In this illustration, we'll analyze a situation when a balloon rises above the earth. Here we are given that a balloon starts rising from earth's surface with a constant speed V0, and due to wind, the balloon gathers a horizontal velocity component Vx, which is Ay, where A is a positive constant and y is its height above the earth's surface. We are required to find the horizontal drift of balloon as a function of height. Here, in this situation, we can draw a picture in which from ground, a balloon starts rising up, and the situation is like this, that in this situation, as balloon goes up, its trajectory would be somewhere here, and the balloon gathers a horizontal drift x along with the vertical rise in its motion, which is denoted here by y. Now, in this situation, it has one velocity in horizontal direction Vx, and it is given that it is going upward with the constant speed Vy, which is equals to V0. Now, in this situation here, we can write, due to uniform speed in y direction, its height as a function of time can be given as y is equals to V0t, as V0 is a constant. And in x direction or in horizontal direction, we can write Vx, which is given as Ay. So, this can be written as AV0t, and Vx can be written as dx by dt, which is equals to AV0t. And here the value of dx we can write as AV0t dt. If we integrate this expression with the t equals to 0, the position was at x equals to 0. This was the position x equals to 0 from where the balloon started. And at time t, it gathers a horizontal drift x. So here we can write x is equals to this AV0t² / 2. As lower limit is 0, we can remove the limit substitution, or we use only the upper limits. So, in this situation, here we can substitute the value of time in terms of height, as here the value of t we can write as y upon V0. So, in this situation, if we see the value of time, so the horizontal drift here we can write as AV0/2 multiplied by y by V0². This equals to A/2V0 multiplied by y². So, this is the horizontal drift gathered by the balloon due to the horizontal component of velocity, which is given as a function of y, the height of ascent of balloon. So, this is the final result of this problem.